Museum is proud to bring listeners democracy.
Hi, this is Richard Hall and from Stonehenge Aotearoa, and this is the night sky. And we've got some interesting things to have a look at in our night sky at the moment. So we'll turn over to some imagery for a moment. There we are. There we go. The night sky. And of course, the wonderful thing about the Wairarapa is that we do have such a beautiful night sky. All right. The only problem is, I think it's the. I can't see the pictures come up again. Anyway, there we go. How's that? They're talking over there. Okay, radio with some pictures. Okay. That's it. Let's try that one. Okay. Okay, looking out at our night sky at the moment, so we move on a little bit. I guess nobody can miss it. Like, as soon as the sun goes down, there's that great big bright star up there in the sky, out in the northwest. And that is, in fact, not a star at all. That's the planet Venus. And in fact, if you can manage to pick up Venus before it gets too dark, and you've got a pair of binoculars, it's getting so close to the Earth, you can actually see its face with a pair of binoculars. So that's Venus there, right? And at the moment it's showing a crescent phase, and above that we've got Jupiter. That'll be the next one that you can see, it's quite clearly seen. And then beyond that we've got the planet Mars. All right, and Mars you can't miss, it's almost directly overhead, it's a reddish in colour. But it's beginning to fade now because the Earth's passed it by and we're sort of receding away from it. And in between Jupiter and Mars is the planet Saturn, right? So those are the bright planets that we can see in the sky at the moment. Then eventually, as it gets dark, all of those are becoming very, very visible. But of course, Venus itself will eventually set. And now we're looking around to the south. And at this time of the year, once it gets dark, you can see the Southern Cross is virtually sitting at its lowest point, upside down, almost absolutely due south. In addition to that, because the Southern Cross is a part of the Milky Way at this time of the year is laying along the southern horizon. So we've got this great scan of bright stars. And of course, if you're in a dark sky site, you'll be able to see the Milky Way as well. So first thing to pick up will be the Southern Cross lower down, and following behind that are what we call the two-pointer stars. Right. This is Alpha and Beta Centauri. Now, the brighter of the two, the second one behind the cross, is Alpha Centauri. And that, of course, is the nearest star beyond the solar system. But, of course, unlike our sun, it's not a single sun. It's two suns orbiting around each other. And we've already discovered planets around these stars out there. So I'll have more to say about that in a later program. And then we look down towards the west and we can see the Scorpion. Now, the Scorpion is the sign of winter. It's a dominant sign in our sky, or constellation in our sky, over the winter months. But now, as we head into spring, in the early evening, we see the Scorpion setting. All right? It's also known as, the fish hook of Maui. Looking over towards the east, we've got the two brightest stars in the sky. And these are true stars, unlike planets. The brightest of the two, of course, to the far east is Sirius. Again, a local star, and the other one is Canopus. That's the second brightest star in the sky. These are just some of the objects we can see when we're looking due south. And if we follow upwards from that, because the Milky Way is low in the sky, we can see what appears to be two detached portions of the Milky Way. Well, these are not detached portions. These are, in fact, satellite galaxies. These are what we call the Large and the Small Magellanic Cloud. Just the same way as the Earth has got, Jupiter's got moons going around it, so our giant galaxy we live in has also got satellites. And these are two of them. And the smaller of the cloud is coming almost directly overhead at the moment in the early evening. And it's got a sort of weird sort of tadpole shape when you look at it through the telescope. And the reason for that is that it's coming so close to the Milky Way, it's literally being shredded and gradually gravitationally distorted by our galaxy. And with the passage of time, it will disappear. And I'm talking about millions and millions of years. It will disappear from our sky altogether as it actually gets absorbed by the Milky Way galaxy. But when you're looking up at the small Magellanic Cloud, you'll see what appears to be a fuzzy star next to it. And indeed, originally it was classified as a star, number 47 in the constellation of Toucan, where the small cloud is. But this fuzzy star is no star at all. In fact, it's what we call a globular cluster. And it's a lot closer. Incidentally, I should point out, when we look at the small cloud, it is, in general, the most distant object you can see with the unaided eye. Its distance is just over 190,000 light years. 47 Toucani is also an enormous distance from us, but it's a lot closer. It's actually orbiting around our galaxy. Its distance is 15,000 light years from us. And it is a gigantic ball of stars, something in the region of 200 light years in diameter. And and at the centre, there is vast numbers of stars. It's got something in the region of 200,000 stars, and they are crowded so close together that I guess if you were in the planet near the centre, the sky would be absolutely crowded with stars, hundreds of them brighter than the full moon. So look, those are some of the things that we can see directly to the south at the moment. But what we're going to do now is we're going to listen to a little piece of music. And this is a listen by Michael Toombs, and we're going to take you along the Milky Way galaxy as we do so.
antiquity. And I'm glad you did. Being with you makes my heart smile. I don't know what you did to me, but I'm damn sure glad you did. You did to me, but I'm damn sure glad you did. Being with you makes my heart so brand new, and you know you do. Being with you makes my heart so brand new. Yes, you know you do.
If you'd like to get involved with Arrow FM 92.7 Access Radio Wairarapa, get in touch. Phone us on 378 0255. You don't need any special training or skills, just something to say or play.
About this, your mama never listened to a word that you say. Simple little words just to make another change. So late in my grave, holding the gaps and they can't get up, pulling up the ropes and they get so tough. Strategy thoughts still among the
top. Hi, folks, you're back with Richard and the night sky. We're turning around and looking to the. As we can see Mars up there, of course, by this time Venus is. Looking up into, we've got this region where the Milky Way is getting very, very low in the sky. So, it's a universe here. It's flying up the Milky Way, which is over in the Aquila, the eagle. And on the tail of the eagle, star, that's called Altair. Altair is a relatively nearby star, but it's a rather interesting object. It's only about 17 light years away. It's hotter than the sun. It's a sort of hot star and rotating extremely rapidly. In fact, it's rotating so fast that it's, instead of being a nice spherical star like our sun, it's like a shaped like a lens. Example, it takes our sun about a month to rotate on its axis. This star, which is twice the mass of our sun, rotates in just around 9 hours. Had Altair as a sun, it would be white hot and it would be like a brilliant lens. In fact, it's rotating so far, it may well eventually. The other thing is that why would a star be rotating so rapidly? And one of the reasons we believe for this is that there was originally a binary star system, and what's happened with the passage of time is the two stars have actually merged together. All right, so that's why we've got Altair up there. Okay, now looking back at our night sky, looking directly north, you can see what we call the Great Square. And it's made up by second magnitude stars, but because there's no other bright stars in the region, it's actually quite easy to see, right? So it's a great square. And then there's a line of stars seeping downwards from that. And if you look down just to the right of the great square, on a clear dark night from here in the Wairarapa, you'll see a hazy patch of light. Now, this is indeed, it's about as high as it comes here in New Zealand. But, of course, in the Northern Hemisphere, this object comes directly overhead, and it is the most distant object that can be seen with the unaided eye. All right? This is, in fact, the great galaxy in Andromeda. All right? And it's an absolutely titanic galaxy. As its distance is 2.3 million light years. And they get this into perspective as we're looking at, so you imagine somebody out there in a star orbiting around the Andromeda galaxy, which incidentally is very similar to the Milky Way galaxy. If it was, we were out there and they could actually look back at the Earth and see the Earth, of course they wouldn't see us because they would be looking back 2.4 million light years years in time. So what they would actually see on this planet is our earliest ancestors out in Africa, all right? Yes, there would be absolutely no sign of civilization here on the Earth, OK? So that's a great galaxy and Andromeda. And as what I was saying earlier, it is a great window into the sky, into the deep regions of space. And this is what we call out there the realm of the galaxies. And with you can't see it with the eyes, but even with a pair of binoculars, you'll pick up patches of faint light. But with large telescopes, you can pick up some magnificent galaxies out there. Right? And we've got Stonehenge. We're going to have a special program because it's there in the sky at the moment called the Andromeda Chain. And we're going to be talking all about these great galaxies. And also, hopefully, if the sky is clear, we'll be having a look at them afterwards. Now, that's going to be on Saturday, October the 13th, starting at 7 p.m. We start off with a presentation. We're going to take you right the way through all these galaxies. And then, hopefully, if it's nice and clear, we'll take you out to the night sky and actually view these through the telescope. Incidentally, one of the things we'll be talking about is the great galaxy and Andromeda. Is actually heading towards us, what we've discovered. And in fact, what we do know is that it's actually going to collide with our galaxy. But we'll explain to you all these exciting things when you come out to see us at, on October the 13th at 7 o'clock. Anyway, what we're going to do is now is we're going to have another little piece of music and we're going to be taking you through the night sky. And and off we go. and it's taken us through to the galaxies and so on, and we're back with the night sky. Well, earlier on, we were looking at the southern sky. Remember, we had the Southern Cross at its lowest point in the sky. But let's return looking back at the southern sky. Well, because there's something interesting that we can see in our night sky at this time of the year, which is rather important to us in New Zealand. You'll all be familiar with the Matariki in the beginning of the new year, all right? And of course, to see Matariki rising and things like that, you've actually got to get up in the very early hours of the morning. But fortunately, at this time of the year, in late October, November, when we look out, we're seeing exactly the same stars that you would see at the beginning of the Maori New Year in the middle of winter, but this time they're rising up in the evening sky. And if you look into the northeast, you'll see this beautiful little cluster of stars rising up. That is, of course, the Pleiades star cluster. And it's a cluster of something like in the region of 400 stars, the largest of which, the seven largest, which we can easily see with the unaided eye on a clear dark night, they are considerably brighter than the sun, about 500, each of those is about 500 times brighter. But there's lots of other stars there. And incidentally, the Pleiades star cluster is very, very young. When I tell you it's actually 50 million years old, you'll think, well, it's pretty old. But for stars, these are babies. Got to remember, our sun is 4.5 billion years old, all right? So these are babies, and they're known as the Seven Sisters, who were the daughters of Atlas. Now, the importance of the Pleiades was that if we're going backwards in time, few thousand years in time, the rising of these stars marked the spring equinox in the Northern Hemisphere. And this marked the beginning of the year for all the peoples of Europe and Asia, right, as they rose up. Well, and because they used to begin the year with the spring equinox. Well, the Polynesians carried this tradition into the Pacific. So to this day, here in New Zealand, we still say the beginning of the year rises with the rising of Matariki, right? So that's what those stars are there. So if we then look around to our, looking back to the south, right, we remember the Milky Way is laying along the horizon. Well, this was said to be the great Waka of Tamariri. The Southern Cross, incidentally, was the anchor of the great Waka in the sky. And then it said at this time, this is in June we're talking about, in the Maori New Year, Tama, he pulls up the anchor, and then the great Waka sails across the sky. And the Waka is the Milky Way, and that's exactly what you will observe. Because after that day, the Milky Way will then lift up and travel across the sky. So anyway, that's what we can see at the moment in our evening sky. And just to remind you that we've got the Andromeda chain coming up at Stonehenge on October the 13th. It's on a Saturday at 7 p.m. All right, and that's going to be irrespective of what the sky conditions are, we're going to be having a really good presentation out there. But hopefully afterwards we're going to take you out and show you galaxies, but also the planets that are in the sky as well. And also, just to finally mention that Stonehenge at the moment is open from Wednesday through to Sunday with guided tours on the weekends at 11 o'clock. So do come out and visit us. Now that I'm winding off now, and this is Richard. And I'll be catching you in the near future.